probably another shock. No matter who we ask, and we ask a lot of people, 24-year-old Kent Gerst is described as a great athlete and a great guy, with speed and power on the field and a gentle demeanor both on and off the field. And that's part of what makes his death so puzzling, because he died following a fight Saturday night in the parking lot of Mountain's Bar and Grill on West Carolina in O'Fallon, Missouri. Police found his body Sunday under the bridge at Peru Creek, a couple of blocks away from the bar. O'Fallon police are not releasing any more details until after they get the medical examiner's report. However, friends report Gerst has been punched several times in the head. They're not sure how he ended up in the water, but they think he's been running to get away from the attack. It's just a tough thing. John Walker is a close family friend of the Gerst, who, like the victim's distraught family, is trying to stay focused on memories of better days. He was just a great kid. He was always smiling and always laughing, and a great athlete, as everyone knows. Just a wonderful, kind kid is the best way I think that I could put it.
He was great. I think he came here towards the end of last season, and I think he hit somewhere around 10 to 12 home runs, which is outstanding in 2 months.
Although Kent Gerst played only half a season with the Grizzlies, the team feels like their family has also suffered a loss.
And the clubhouse, an awesome kid. The guys that were with him last year, I know they just after that too. Just a great clubhouse guy, quiet. Sneaky funny, we called him. Just a blast to be around him.
According to the team manager, Kent Gerst was released from the Grizzlies at the end of last season because of the salary cap in the league. Since then, he's been living at home and working for the city of O'Fallon.